Okay, so we're back in the kitchen and we have our brisket. We're using the Cabela's commercial grade 11 inch cut to size vacuum bag rolls. These are rolls that you cut and make into bags. So they're not pre-cut bags. And we're using the Cabela's Pro Series vacuum sealer. This particular model takes 12 inch rolls. These are 11 inch rolls, but they will work with this vacuum sealer. We have our brisket here. And this video is just the way that I do things. I'm not a professional butcher. These are just ways that I found work best for me. So let's get started. What I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna make sectional cuts. This piece of meat is too big to fit into one bag with this vacuum sealer. So I'm gonna look at this and I'm gonna basically create a grid. I'll make a cut here, here, and here. And if I have to, after making those cuts, I'll make a cut down the middle of them also. Just because the sizes of them will still be kind of large. They can fit into the bag, but sometimes you tend to not get all the air out of it. So if I make one more smaller cut down the middle, it's more likely that all the air will come out when the bag is sealed up. So let's make our cuts here. Just start making here. So we're making our cuts now, and let's come take a closer look. So these knives I'm using are just, there's nothing special about them. They're just regular knives that my wife bought on Amazon. They are Japanese steel or German steel, if that matters to anybody. But as long as you have a sharp knife, this will work just fine. It doesn't matter what kind of steel it is. Again, I ain't no professional butcher. I just use what works for me. So we have our first section cut. Let's get our next section. What you want to make sure you do when you're cutting these pieces of meat is you want a slicing motion. I know sometimes people tend to just push down with the blade and that will get you a cut, but it'll get you a rough cut. So what you want to do is have a nice slicing forward and backward motion as you make your cut. It'll make your job a lot easier. And of course the fat is always the hardest part to cut. And the recommendation is always to make cuts with the grain, but in this case, because the slab of meat is so big and I have to cut these down into smaller pieces, cutting with the grain would kind of, it would give me odd sized pieces of meat. And I kind of want a nice rectangle or square shape. So again, this is just what works for me here. Okay, so we got this cut here now. This piece is definitely gonna have to be cut down more because it's just a really thick piece. So I'm gonna cut this down into smaller pieces. We'll probably do this one last. We'll work our way, in fact, we'll work with this one first and work our way this way. So this piece is still pretty large, so I am gonna cut these down the middle right here. This is a brand new cutting board that I'm using, by the way. My family got this for me as a gift. And what I really like about this cutting board is it has really large gutters. There's some really nice cutting boards that are really thick and they don't have gutters. And what happens is if you have something, you're cutting meat or vegetables, the juices just run off and get onto the countertop. And this countertop anyway, it's hard to see with the color of the countertop. It's hard to see if there's food on the countertop. So I like cutting boards that have gutters. Oh yeah, it's cutting nice and smooth. This piece is pretty thick, but I think we'll be able to get it to work. All right, for the big mamma jamma. Let's see. I want to make my cuts to where, like, I wouldn't make a cut here because I would just have way more fat than to meat, the fat to meat ratio. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to make my cut down the middle. And I think with this piece, that will be just fine. I think we'll be able to work with that. Yeah, I think we'll be good with that. Okay, so we have our cuts of meats. We're gonna put a roll into this vacuum sealer. Right now it's currently empty, so let's get a roll in there. Let's put this in here. So we're gonna roll out our material. Here, we cut our bag material. Now we have to seal one end of this bag material. You want to make sure that this is right on the edge of that rubber gasket. And make sure that there's no creases or kinks in it. We'll just set this down. The first lock is the storage position. The second lock is where it locks the bag into place. And you know you're locked into place because the LEDs come on. Then we're gonna hit manual seal. The blue light is lit, it's done. So we can pop this open. And you see, there you go. You have a nice sealed bag on one end. Now when we seal the opened end, you want to bring it into where these little tabs are. Set it just underneath there, and then we're going to press, just make sure we don't have any creases over that gasket again. You can see it sealing up the meat, getting all the air out of the bag. And then there's a progress bar. You have orange lights. Once it gets to the last light, which is blue, it'll finish. I don't lift up the handle though until it shuts off. It'll shut off in a second here. Okay, now it's done. Open it up. And we got a nicely vacuum sealed cut of meat. You can see the space that we left up top. If that space was not left, you can see where the seal would be down and it would likely not be able to seal, or there would be stress on the bag wanting to open it up because it would be so close to the meat, so close to where it was, where the air was sucked out. So this space up here up top is very important. All right, we'll do the rest and we'll see what it looks like when we're all done. Okay, so now we have all of our meat cuts vacuum sealed. Next step is to write what the meat is and the date that it was vacuum sealed. So this is a brisket. And today's date is August 13th, 23. So we'll do this with all of the meats. Thank you. And there we have it. That's all of our meat cuts from today's purchase. We are going to freeze them today. We vacuum sealed them and we're going to freeze them today on October 13th, 2023. These meat cuts will be good for the next year. Okay, so that's our video. Please like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. If you like more of this content, please leave a comment. If you want to see other content, such as our camping, hunting, fishing expeditions, or hiking, or reviews of other products, products that I personally own and have purchased with my own money, please let me know in the comment section. Thanks again. Thanks for hanging out. We'll see you next time.